Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 8 through 12, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 5th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
So, we have been discussing for the last few days about the process of knowledge. So we have discussed already amanittam, humbleness, amanittam, abhammittam, ahimsa, ahimsa, non-violence. So ahimsa, khanti, tolerance, arjavam, simplicity. These things we have already discussed. Now, another important thing is acharya upasanam. If you want to make progress, then you have to approach acharya. Just like if you want to be educated, you go to school, you go to college, you go to university. Similarly, if you want to be advanced in knowledge, knowledge means not this material knowledge. Actual knowledge is to advance in spiritual knowledge. Just in this Bhagavad Gita, the beginning of knowledge was instructed by Krishna that I am not this body. Dehi-na-sindhita-dehi-kaumāna-yoga-nandara. I am encased in this body, I am not this body. Unfortunately, at the present moment, this is accepted knowledge, bodily concept. I am India, I am America, I am Brahmana, I am Kshatriya. This is the actually, the knowledge begins when one understands, I am not American, I am not Indian, I am not Brahmana, I am not Kshatriya. Then what you are? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Gopi Bhakta Padakamalu Dasa Dasa Anudasa. I am the servant of the servant of the servant of Krishna, the provider of the gopis, Gopi Bhakta. That is my real identification, not this body. So, to understand this knowledge, one has to approach acharya. Acharya means one who knows the purpose of Vedic literature, shastra. Achina pija shastram. And practices and teaches his disciples. He knows, acharya means knows, one who knows the purpose of Vedic literature. He practices in his life and he teaches his disciples. He is called acharya. So acharya upasana, before worshipping the Lord, just like here, Krishna said, in the beginning, acharya upasana, and in the middle, he says, mai cha ananya yogena bhakti abhyavicharini. So before engaging yourself in devotional service to the Lord, you must first of all worship acharya, acharya upasana. One cannot become a devotee personally, just like Savrasthar said, what is the use of accepting Guru? Of course they have got very bad experience, but who is acharya? Acharya means one who has received the Vedic knowledge through the parampara system. Even parampara praptam vimangaraja sayo guru. He is acharya. acharya cannot be manufactured, self-made. No, he must come down from the disciplic succession. He is acharya. You have to approach such acharya. He is coming in disciplic succession. Acharyaman purusha veda, one who is under the shelter of acharya, he knows things. So Krishna recommends also, yes, that if you actually want to become in knowledge, if you want to have real knowledge, then you must worship acharya, acharya. This is very system. Tadvijnanartham sadgurum eva abhigacchet. It is not that if I like I can go to a guru, if I don't like I can learn the books at home and learn everything. No, that is not that. Practically, just like if you purchase some medical book and study at home, and if you begin to practice, you will be called a quack. You will not be recognized by the government. You will not get the practitioner registration. Unless you have passed through the medical college, your medical examination, you will not be accepted. Even if you say that I have read all the books. Similarly, if you simply think that I have read, then I will see generally, oh, I have read Bhagavad Gita 100 times. But you asking what is Krishna, he cannot see. Because he has not approached the acharya. This is difficult. He might have read Bhagavad Gita 1,000 times, but he will not understand a single word. Because he has not approached. Therefore Vedic literature says, tadvijnanartham sa guru meva avigacchet. Avigacchet, this bhag is used when the sense is you must. This is beginning form of bhag, gacchet, avigacchet. You must. There is no excuse. You cannot learn. Tasmād gurum prabuddhita jityāsu sreya uttamam. If you want to know uttamam subject matter, ut means udgatam, transcending. Tamam means this material world. This material world is tamo, darkness. But if you are interested in the matter which is transcendental to this material world, that means spiritual world, then tasmāt guruṁ pravadvetā, you must surrender to a guru. Jignyasu seva uttamam, not ordinary jignyasu. Just like we go to the market, what is the rate of this share, what is the rate of rice, what is the rate of that. Not that kind of brahma jignyasu. Athāta brahma jignyasu. This human life is meant for inquiring about brahma, not the rice, dal, share market, no. So jignyasu seva uttamam. What is the highest perfection of life? He requires to approach a guru. It is not a fashion. It is not a fashion that I have made my guru, such and such sound. But what you have learned, you cannot learn, because you are not at all jignasu. You do not know how to inquire. Neither the guru you have met, he does know how to reply. Such kind of guru and disciple will not help. The disciple must be also serious to understand about the spiritual subject matter. That is knowledge. Brahma jignasu. One who is inquisitive to know about the absolute truth, he requires to approach a guru. That is jnana. Jnana means brahma jnana. Aham brahmasmi. This is jnana. If I am American, that is not Gyan, that is your Gyan. I am Indian, I am Brahman, I am this, I am that, I am black, I am white, I'm bad, I'm clean. These are all objects. Ignorance. You are neither fat, nor thin, nor black, nor white, nor American, but you are spirit soul. You have to know that. Aham Brahmasmi. I am spirit soul. I am eternal servant of Krishna. That is knowledge. And for this knowledge, you must approach Acharyupasanam, Saucham, cleanliness. That is very essential. This morning I was talking with Kamal Krishna Goswami. Cleanliness is, as soon as you give up cleanliness, you become Mlecha and Javan. Mlecha, Javan, these two names have come in the Vedic Shastra. One who is unclean. Why? There was always misunderstanding between the Hindus and the Muslims. I'm talking a practical life. Because the Muslims were very unclean. And the Hindus were, suppose now Hindus are less than Muslims. Less than Muslims. And still they are claiming social. They are most unclean at the present moment. So this is your attack. Publicly, it is being advertised. Here is big song, come on. Equality. Equality by eating beef. Drinking wine. Now, this is coming. Saucham. Saucham, cleanliness. Cleanliness is next to godliness. You must take twice bath at least. It is required. And in tropical countries like India, there is no difficulty taking bath 3 times. Of course, if your body does not permit. But that is saucham, to clean. Saucham, saucham bhajha prantaram. Apovitra pavitrava sarvavastam bhutubhiva jasmare pundarikaktam sa bhaiya abhantram suci. The Brahman is called therefore Suci. He is always clean. Taking 3 times bath, cloth washed, mouth, hands, legs, all clean with pillow. That is Brahman. So. This is externally. And internally, you have to become also Sautam. Bhadhabhantra. Bhaya means externally you have to cleanse yourself with water, soap or earth, and internally you have to be cleansed by chanting Hare Krishna Mahal. Chita Darpana Madhyam. Because if you remain unclean within the heart, simply by washing your external body and cleansing your cloth, that is not complete cleanliness. That may be called hygiene. But real cleanliness is internally and externally. Jasmare pundarika kamsa bhaya abhantaram suci. You have to cleanse yourself externally and internally by remembering jasmare pundarika kham, the lotus eyes, Krishna, if you always think, that is suci. And in Bengali, there is a poetry. Muchi hoye suchi hoy, jodi Krishna hoye. If one is Krishna conscious, even if he is born in a cobbler's family, muchi. In India, there are two things, muchi and suchi. Suchi means perfect Brahman, and muchi means cobbler, the shoemaker. So, muchi hoye suchi hoy, jodi Krishna hoy. If one becomes Krishna conscious, even if he is born in the family of a muchi, chama, he can become a Brahman. And suchi hoye muchi hoy, jodi Krishna tyagi. And if he gives up Krishna, even if he is born in a Brahman family, he becomes a muchi. Muchi means the skin expert. If he is simply busy, and the skin, Brahman skin. Your behavior? No, that doesn't matter. So that means skinish part, just like Mushi, knows how to distinguish whether it is cow's skin or goat's skin or this skin. No. One must be Krishna conscious, then he is clean. Samayam bhantaram sushi, jasmane punyaritakam. This is Krishna conscious. Manvana bhavamadhaktam adhyajimam nosku. One who is always thinking of Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Ram, Hare Ram. He is sushi. He is not Muchi. Muchi hai sushi hai, Jari Krishna bhaji. So it's just atma-vinigra. Controlling the senses, atma-vinigra. That is called shami, goshami. If you can control your senses, vacha-vegam, krodha-vegam, if you can control your force of talking nonsense, because generally we talk nonsense, then if you can control you are talking of nonsense things, then you become controller of talking. Vāca-vegam, krodha-vegam. Naturally, because we are generally affected with rajas-tamo-guna, rajas-guna especially, and tamo-guna, we become angry, all at a sudden. So you have to control that. Vāca-vegam, krodha-vegam, manaso-vegam. Mind is very restless. So you have to control the mind. You cannot allow the mind to do anything and everything, but it must be controlled. Sarinamātma-vinigraha. Indriyārtheṣu vairāgyam. Indriyārtheṣu. For the matter of sense gratification, you have to practice vairāgya. Indriya are all the indriyas, eyes, tongue, nose. They are very much affected or attracted. I always attracted by beauty. I want to see very beautiful things. Like you can control the eyes when you practice to see the beautiful feature of Lord Krishna and Rāda. Therefore, the deity should be very nicely decorated. So, laymen like us may be attracted by the beauty of Rāda Krishna. Gradually, he'll forget to see any other beauty. This is the practice of Indriyārtheṣu. Indriyārtheṣu vairāgyam. Actually, the whole life is made for understanding vairāgya, renouncement. Human life is not meant for becoming more and more attached to the material enjoyment. Human life is made for tapasya, vairāgya. Here it is said, vairāgyam, anahankāra. False prestige, false identification. Oh, I am this, I must do this. That is, in the beginning, it is called amanittam, anahankaram. Janmamrityu jarabhyadi dukkha dushanam darshan. We are very much busy to make solution of the problems of life, political problems, economical problems, social problems. They are also problems. But real problem is janmamrityu jarabhyadi, that you have to take birth, you have to die, and when you are in life, you have to suffer from diseases, jara, you have to become old. Janmamrityu jarabhyadi dukkha. These are really problems. But who knows that these are the real problems? They are taken it, accepted it. Krishna says this is knowledge. If you are scientifically advanced, how to stop death, how to stop birth, how to stop old age, how to stop disease, then you should know that you have advanced in science. Otherwise, what is this? If you have made this horseless carriage, put a car, that is not advancement. It is advancement, but it is not the solution of the problem. The solution of problem is human life, is to how to stop death. Therefore, Shastras say that nobody should become guru, nobody should become father, nobody should become husband. In this way there is a need. Namo chayabja samupeta mrittum. If one cannot help his student or his son or his subordinate to stop death, actually this is the problem. Namo chayabja samupeta mrittum. We are under the clutches of death. It is as sure as death. So this human life is made for stopping this death. But if you don't see that this is the problem, that is avgyana. That is ignorance. If you don't accept this is the problem, if you simply think my problem is how to eat, how to sleep, how to have sex life, how to defend, these problems are already solved, even by of the birds and the bees. These are not the problems. They are already set up. Real problem is here. Janma mitu jarabbedi dukkho dosha anudarshanam. Another problem is asakti. We are very much attached to our so-called home, so-called wife, children. And here is a gyan means that asakti is an abhishanam. Asakti. You should, therefore, at a certain age, according to Vedic civilization, one is forced to give up this attachment. Naturally, one is attached to wife, children, home, but Vedic civilization says that is all right. From up to 50 years, you can remain attached. But, panchasuddham manam vade, after your 50th year, you must give up your family life. Manavare, go to the forest for tapasya. That was the system. Here at the present moment, everywhere all over the world, when he is going to die, still he is attached to his political life, social life, family life. That is not knowledge, that is ignorance. You must be detached. Vairagyam, anabhisanga, puttadhara grihadashi, family life. Putra means children, dhara means wife, griha means home. Puttadhara grihadashi, asakti, anabhisanga, nittam cha samachittattam istanishta upapatti. In this way, you have to situate, you have to be situated on the devotional service. Devotional service is not sentiment. Just like Krishna, after describing so many stages of advancement of knowledge, then he says, Maicha Ananna Yogina Bhakti Rabdhavichari. Ananna Yogina. Always yoga means linking up. Always linking up with Krishna. Mai. Krishna says Mai and to me. Krishna. Maicha Ananna Yogina Bhakti Yogina. So you can be attached to Krishna if you have adopted in the service of Krishna. Not casually, but constantly.
Maicha Ananna Yogina Bhakti Yogina Abhyavichari.
Abhyavichari means without breath. Always, constantly. Satatam kirtayantam maam jatam tashtadivabhrata. In another place Krishna says, Satatam kirtayantam maam. Always glorify me. This is Krishna consciousness movement. Always we have to glorify Krishna. We should go, meet people, preach and glorify Krishna. We beg for Krishna. We print books for Krishna. We distribute books for Krishna. We carry for Krishna. We eat for Krishna. We sleep for Krishna. So, everything should be adopted with Krishna, that is called ananya yogena, without any break, constantly 24 hours in Krishna consciousness of Bhagavachari.
Vivikta desa sevittam arati jana samsadhi.
Arati jana samsadhi. Not very much attached with general public, because they are not Krishna conscious. We can meet them as far as possible, as far as required. Not that we have to sit down and talk all nonsense with the general people, no. Arati jana samsadhi. Naturally, we shall be inclined to avoid such conflict. That preaching war, we have to go, not to associate with him, but to give your association to him. That should be principle. Because you have learned something about devotion and service, you should give your experience to such person, but not to accept their behavior. If you keep this in view, then you will be treated. And if you become victimized by his association, then you are doomed. You should give him the opportunity of your association. Whatever you know, whatever you have learned about Bhakti Yoga, when you go to meet a person, you should try to inform him, this is Krishna consciousness, you also take to it. Jai Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Jari Rakhu Tari Kaho Krishna. Kaho Krishna Kaho. Krishna Bodhis. Jari Rakhu Tari Kaho Krishna Bodhis. This is Jari.
Adhyatma Gyanam
Nityatam. Spiritual knowledge. That is eternal knowledge. It is not great. If you learn spiritual knowledge, a little of it in this life, sarvamapiyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bhaya, then you will save from the greatest danger.
Tattva jnanartha darsana.
If you want to become philosopher, then you philosophize for understanding the tattva jnana. And what is tattva jnana? Vadanti tattva vidas tattvam jagyanam adhyam. Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti, Shabda. That is Tattva-gyan. Truth. What is that truth? Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti. To understand about Brahma, to understand about Paramatma, to understand about the Supreme Personality of God, that is Tattva-gyan. Thank you very much.